Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. So this is a very important series that we're going to be starting out with today. Essential VARC concepts. Now, what is the need for this series? When you say essential VARC concepts, this is important not just for the CAT 2021 aspirants, but also for the CAT 2020 aspirants. Reason being, when we solve advanced practice exercises, when we solve previous year question papers, when we've been going through various mocks and various sectionals, what I have noticed and what you all have shared with me as well, is that many questions you're going wrong with because you've forgotten the basics. You know, we've gotten so used to but the practice, the drill, you know, the practice, drill, that we have forgotten the basics, and sometimes it becomes very important for us to go back to the drawing board, check whether our basics are right, and then continue with our practice. So these sessions, Essential VARC Concept Series, we're going to look at some of the most important concepts when it comes to odd one out, when it comes to para jumbles, para completion, para summary, reading comprehension, all the important areas. Because once our concepts are strong, once our basics are strong, then nobody can stop us from achieving 100% accuracy and 100 percentile in the CAT exam. Also, CAT 2021 aspirants, please make sure that you go through these concepts, that you make sure that your foundation is very strong, and from there on, we can build on it. Okay, so everyone, what are we waiting for? Let's begin. So today's topic is odd one out patterns. When it comes to odd one out, a very common misconception that a lot of students have is, okay, you see four or five sentences, one which is off topic, one which is irrelevant, one which is out of context, that's all. They either say out of context or irrelevant or, you know, it a different topic, and that's it. No, there are various patterns, there are various types of questions, there are various ways in which we can arrive at the right odd one out. So let's have a look at the important patterns with the help of examples. Okay, so come on, let's begin with the session. So I want to remind everybody to subscribe to the channel CAT for MBA Live daily. If you want to crack not just CAT exam, but CAT, MAT, GMAT, any management entrance exam that you're looking for, TIS, SNAP, all of them, subscribe to the channel, because every single topic, every single area, be it LR, be it DI, be it quantitative aptitude, be it VARC, be it GK, every single area, you can prep for every single area through the channel CAT for MBA Live daily. So hit the subscribe button. For your VARC preparation, I want all of you to join the VARC prep group, Unacademy _ Ritu Dudhoria on Telegram. The link is in the description below. Just click on the link and join the group for all the guidance, all the links to the sessions. Subscribe to the channel, join the group. Very crucial at this stage is to take the Unacademy Plus subscription. CAT 2020 aspirants, you do not want to miss out on the final courses that all your educators are launching for you. Practice courses, detailed courses, must-solve courses, essential question courses, sectionals, practice throughout. So take the subscription. CAT 2021 aspirants, very important to start now, so that in the next year, you practice, you give a lot of mocks, you give a lot of sectionals, but your concepts need to be strong. You have to take the Unacademy Plus subscription, because one-time subscription gives you access to all the educators, all their courses, all the mocks, all the sectionals, and preparation for all the areas. And when you're taking the subscription, I want all of you to use the code RITUMBA. No other code, guys. Only RITUMBA in order to get 10% off. Please attend the special classes on the Unacademy Live, Unacademy Learning app. These are live, free, live special classes on the Unacademy Learning app. Go through my previous plus courses, reading comprehension, critical reasoning, para jumbles, para summary, odd one out, and also enroll for the ongoing course, that is, which began in on November 4th. So enroll for the course, watch the sessions, download the PDFs, doubt solving sessions, very crucial. Everything that we can do in order to achieve that 100% accuracy in the VARC section for CAT 2020. Now, let's have a look at the various patterns or the basis on which you can select the odd one out with examples. Now, the first pattern is the apples, and what I would like to call is the apples and oranges pattern, which I think a lot of students just feel that this is the only pattern when it comes to odd one out. So no, guys, a big myth which we're going to debunk now. This is an important pattern, but it is a basic odd one out pattern. But a lot of questions in the CAT exam especially are not basic odd one out questions anymore. They have become advanced odd one out questions anymore, for which there are other patterns which we will look at. But it's very important to also understand that yes, sometimes our questions can be based on the apples and oranges pattern. What is the apples and oranges pattern? Now, for instance, you have four sentences. Three sentences would be talking about apples. One sentence would be talking about oranges. So if three sentences are talking about apples and one sentence is talking about oranges, you can say that oranges is going to be my odd one out because it is off topic, because it is out of context. Three sentences are talking about India. One sentence talks about a situation in Japan. You can say that Japan is my odd one out because, you know, the other, it's off topic or it's out of context. We have to be very careful while eliminating in this way. So this is, I would say this is not the best approach, but this is one approach which a lot of students tend to use. But generally, guys, you cannot answer all questions based on this approach. Your accuracy rate also dips down when you go through this approach. There are better approaches which we will have a look at, but let's understand this approach as well. Let's see an example for this approach as well. So apples and oranges approach. Now just have a look at the four sentences here, guys. Come on, let's solve it and let's pick the odd one out. Now look at sentence number one. One reason to worry about the timing of your first job is that it often negatively or positively influences your future earning power. So this talks about reason to worry. It talks about timing of your first job and it talks about influences your future earning power. So you have understood the keywords. This summer, Yale economist Lisa Khan completed a study that found that every 15 years after they entered the workforce, first job, college graduates who first went to work, in a weak economy, timing of your first job, tended to have lower incomes. Your future earning power was influenced. They tended to have lower incomes. But the persistent lower pay suggests that workers who stumble getting their first job, remain somewhat lower skilled. This talks about skills. This is how the normal salary arc of a professional life is. One paycheck builds on another. Now, if you have analyzed all the four sentences, it talks about the timing of your first job and it talks about the earning potential. Lower income. This also talks about the earning potential. Option 4 also talks about pay, or it also talks about the earning potential. Which sentence talks about an irrelevant point, or which sentence gives us the orange among these apples? That is 3. Because this talks about skill, whereas no other statement has talked about skill. So that is why in this question, the odd one out which you can enter into the box is 3. Did all of you understand this? Hopefully, guys, you've got the idea of what apples and oranges really mean. So three sentences talk about timing and earning potential, but one sentence talks about difficulty in getting the job, not necessarily timing, but difficulty in getting the job. And it talks about the skill level. So that is why 3 becomes your odd one out. Safe bet. So this was the apples and oranges approach. Come on, let's have a look. So this is how you can solve a basic odd one out question. Now let's have a look at the other approaches through which we can solve advanced odd one out questions. Now guys, the approaches that I'm going to share with you are very, very crucial, compiled and, with the help of examples and questions over the years. So please make sure that you're noting them down. Please make sure that you watch this video again and again. Please make sure that you understand these approaches, because trust me, this video is the only video which can ever provide you the various patterns of odd one out, which is very crucial for all the students. Okay, let's have a look at the next one. The second approach is called as the logical sequence approach. Now, most of you would have heard this last one out approach. Now, you must be thinking, but it is the odd one out. So how can you say that it's the last one out? Now, there are certain reasons behind this, guys, and we're also going to see a little bit of variation to this. But this approach, that is the logical sequence approach, is the best method. It is the most accurate method of solving an odd one out question. What is the logical sequence approach? When you see the question, treat the question as a para jumble question. Do not treat it as an odd one out question. Treat it as a para jumble question. Assume that all the statements are a part of the paragraph. So how you would go about arranging, you know, in a para jumble question, arrange it. Any statement which does not fit, any statement for which you're not able to find a place for it, or any statement which comes last in your sequence becomes the odd one out. So that is the basic concept of a last one out, or that is the basic concept of a logical sequence pattern. Now, there are two problems which generally students face in this approach, and I'm sure this question has come into your minds as well. Ki ma'am, para jumble hi nahi hota hai pehle to theek se. Uske upar aap bol rahe ho ki odd one out mein bhi para jumble karo. So, wo problem hoga. And the second thing that may come into your minds is ki, you know, aap theek hai, par arrange to kar denge, par kya pata hamara order sahi hai ya nahi hai. Or, you know, how can we be sure that the last one itself is the odd one out? Maybe we've missed out some other keyword. Maybe we've missed out. So guys, what I want you to understand over here is it's not important to make a completely beautiful sequence and a perfect sequence like how you would make in a para jumble. No. All I want you to understand here is that you have to form links. You have to form links. Any statement which is not linked to the other statement becomes your odd one out. And also what really works out here is the technique of categorization, what we follow in para jumbles as well. Categorization kya hai? Aap logical basis pe categorize karo. Now, if four statements are talking about a problem and one statement is talking about solution, you will say logically solution baad mein aayega. So, wo last mein hum log laga sakte hain. Right. So, guys, this approach is basically about forming links. If you find that one statement is not linked, then you take that as your odd one out. But if you find that all the statements are linked, sabke sab baith rahe hai, sabke sab fit baith rahe hai, sabke sab topic se related hi hai, sabke sab, you know, how do I, then you take out the last one out. Now, let's understand the logic behind this with the help of this example. To aapko thoda sa aur clearly samajh mein aayega. Come on, let's look into this. According to the influential US strategist, Bernard Brody, writing in 1978, From now on, the chief purpose of military forces must be to avert wars. It must be to avert wars, or it must be to avoid wars. So you can say that this is more as a solution, or this is more as a course of action. Theek hai. So I assume that all of you will read the question, guys. Main aapko categorization ka method samjha rahi hu. Thus, language clues are very important. Nuclear deterrence was born. Vocabulary is very crucial, guys. Deterrence kya hota hai? Deterrence ka matlab hota hai avoid karna. So nuclear deterrence, to avoid, was born. A seemingly rational arrangement by which peace and stability were to arise by the threat of mutually assured destruction. So kyunki, you know, countries feel ki agar if I'm going to use my nuclear arsenal against that country, they are also going to retaliate, to mutually destruct hoga. इससे बेटर ये है कि हम लोग न्यूक्लियर यू नो वॉर या न्यूक्लियर आर्सेनल यूज करना अवॉइड करें और इससे पीस एंड स्टेबिलिटी बिल्ड होगी. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो समथिंग विच इज पॉजिटिव. दिस ऑल्सो कैन बी लुक्ड एज अ सोल्यूशन बिकॉज इट सेज दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूक्लियर डेटरेंस का जो सोल्यूशन है दैट वॉज बॉर्न. सो वी कैन ऑल्सो लुक एट दिस एज अ कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन. अंटिल द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स बॉम्बिंग्स ऑफ हिरोशिमा एंड नागासाकी 1945, the overriding purpose of military forces had ostensibly been, ostensibly means clearly visible, what seems to be the reason, was to win wars. So this is talking about until 1945, military force ka purpose tha ki humko jeetna hai, we have to win wars. Winston Churchill described it in 1955 with characteristic vigor, safety will be the sturdy child of terror, survival the twin brother of annihilation. Annihilation means destruction. So this option also talks about safety, it also talks about survival. Thoda sa aapko lag raha hoga ki technical hai, chhod dena better hai, but no guys, we are not going to leave these questions. Trust me, any question which gives you a lot of grammatical links is actually a question that you should attempt, be it in odd one out or be it in para jumbles. Importantly, deterrence became not only a purported strategy, but the very grounds on which deterrence, what deterrence? Nuclear deterrence. It became a strategy. Okay. But the very grounds on which government justified nuclear weapons themselves. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस पैसेज एंड लेट्स अरेंज इट. ठीक है, अब हम लोग इसका लॉजिकल सीक्वेंस या लिंक्स बनाने की कोशिश करते हैं. So now this looks like a solution. This looks like a solution. This also talks about safety. It talks about survival as a solution. This also talks about it as a strategy or a solution. So which is the only statement which speaks about the problem? Ki pehle problem tha kya? So look at three. So we are going to begin with three. Three says that first, the only reason for military forces was to win wars. It was only about winning wars. Okay. But uske baad se, From now on, the chief purpose, this talks about the earlier purpose of military forces. This talks about now the chief purpose of military forces must be to avert wars. It must be to avoid wars. Which other statement talks about avoiding wars? Two talks about avoiding wars. Nuclear deterrence. Avoid it. Nuclear deterrence. See, I'm not saying that this is going to be my best order or this is the perfect order according to para jumbles, but jaise jaise humko samajh mein aata hai. So 3, 1, 2 have been linked to each other. Now, what is left? 4 is left and 5 is left. 5 says deterrence became a purported strategy, the very ground. So this also talks about deterrence or nuclear deterrence. 5B, we can say it's linked. 4 says Winston Churchill described it. This talks about the opinion of Winston Churchill. Described it. What? Probably deterrence, nuclear deterrence. Safety will be the sturdy child of terror survival. So it looks good to end the paragraph on this note. Na ki, okay, this is a quote by Winston Churchill and this aptly applies to this situation. So I can end the paragraph with 4. So which is your odd one out? Your odd one out becomes 4. Did all of you understand this? Dekho, simple si approach thi. Very simple approach. We started with 3 because that gave us the earlier reason for using military forces. Then it talks about the change which happened. It must be to avert wars or avoid wars. So thus nuclear deterrence was born. A nuclear deterrence born when? This also talks about deterrence. Okay, it became a very important strategy. And is strategy ko Winston Churchill ka quote se end kiya gaya hai. So this becomes our odd one out. This clearly becomes your odd one out. Now what is the funda of last one out? The funda of last one out is the reason why the last one out becomes the odd one out is because this sentence is not that important. It's not that important. It is dispensable. Agar hum isko nikal denge, to bhi hamare passage ya paragraph mein koi zyada fark nahi padega. That is called as your last one out. Or this sentence can be, you know, sometimes the last one out could be a sentence which can start the next para. So, wo hum log bolenge ki is para mein zaruri nahi hai, ye next para ke liye fit baithta hai. So, that is the logic when you look at last one out. It's not that important. Anyway, we are putting it at the end. So, end mein hai, usko pura nikal hi do. So, that is the logic when you look at last one out. Clear, guys? Hope you have understood this. Okay? Come on, let's go to the third pattern. Very important. This is something that I found out that not a lot of you have been using. Or iske baare mein we have discussed in our sessions also a lot of times. Ki independent statement becomes your odd one out. Now, what is an independent statement? Same thing, guys. Ab baar baar dekhoge to same logic hi baith raha hai. Independent statement is a statement which is not linked to any other statement. Link hi nahi baith raha hai. It is not linked to any other statement. It is not that important. Isiliye kisi aur statement se joda nahi gaya hai. You can easily take that out. Now let's look at this example. Okay, Miller's other sporting import, rugby, had less appeal. Okay, wait guys, you go through this passage ek baar. I'll give you 2 minutes. Aap log padho and then we will discuss it. Okay, ek baar just read it once. Come on everyone. Go through this. Try to form odd one out. Generally 5 sentences ke hote hain, but you don't have to keep that as a misconception. Ki it can be a 4 sentences also. Very rare, but still you can find odd one out questions with 4 sentences, and also odd one out questions consisting of 5 sentences. Come on, focus on the logical links. Remember guys, the best approach to answer an odd one out question is to build links. Treat it as a para jumble question. But uske liye ek important point hai ki first itself when you're reading all the 5 statements, ek assumption mat bana lena. Ya don't think, achha, I think this is the odd one out, and then you try to fit the rest around it. Or you try to make a paragraph out of the remaining. So don't keep that, already select one and then treat it as a para jumble question and frame links. No, that will not work. instead first treat it as a para-jumble question, build links, then arrive at your odd one out. Don't form opinions before forming links. Okay, come on. Now, I'm sure you've all gone through this question. Let's understand this. Miller's other sporting import, rugby, had less appeal. Other sporting import, rugby, less appeal, Miller. Asked which sport would grow most Brazilians picked rugby than others in a survey conducted in 2011 by Deloitte. When Charles Miller, this is giving the full name of Miller, son of an English railway engineer posted to Brazil, returned to Sao Paulo from a British boarding school, he brought back a football and popularized a game that would help define Brazilian identity. But now rugby is beginning to find a mass audience. It was played at a few posh boarding schools and almost nowhere else. Now, if you've got your odd one out already, that's very good. Guys, odd one out two hai. Okay, chalo. Jinko nahi mila hai, ek baar explanation sun lo. Jinko mila hai, just see whether the strategy is right or not. See, I'm sure that all of you will agree that three is going to be our opening sentence. Correct? So this looks like a general statement. It looks like the beginning of a narration. It gives us the full name of the person. So I'm going to start with three. Son of an English railway engineer. Okay, he brought back a football and popularized a game. This became popular. Football popular ban gaya tha. That would define Brazilian identity. Now, which other statement talks about Charles Miller? One, Miller's other sporting import. Other than what? Other than football. Rugby had less appeal. Now, very important to note, less appeal. Less matlab in comparison. This is a comparative degree of adjective. Less appeal. Less appeal than what? Less appeal than football. So, football became very popular. Rugby, the other import, had less appeal. Why import? Because football also, he brought it from Britain. And rugby also, he has imported it from another nation. It had less appeal. Now, it had less appeal. Which option shows that, yes, it had less appeal? Five. It was played at a few posh boarding schools and almost nowhere else. Kahi pe bhi nahi khela jata tha. Matlab zyada nahi khela jata tha. Not, it was not very popular. It was almost nowhere else. So, five. But now, rugby. But, focus on the contradiction word. So, this was negative. Ki did not have much appeal. But now rugby is beginning to find a mass audience. So 3, 1, 5, 4 easily linked. Now 2 is your independent statement. Dekho, 3 and 1 we can link together because it talks about Miller. Correct. 5 and 4 we can link together because it talks about less appeal and now more appeal because of the contradiction word but. Which sentence is independent? 2. Plus there are various ways to analyze this. Now dekho, this talks about a survey. Does any other statement talk about the survey? No. This talks about most Brazilians picked rugby. This may be, a present study or, study which was conducted in 2011. What was the repercussion of this study? Which sport? None of, after 2011, what happened? So, this is, ye agar aap study conduct karoge, so iske baad wale jo sentences aayenge, that should be more futuristic. None of the statements are futuristic. So, this is independent. There is no statement which talks about the study. There is no statement which talks about the survey again. There is no statement which talks about the repercussions of the survey. There is no how the findings of the survey has been used. So this becomes an independent statement. And because it's your independent statement, it becomes your odd one out. Clear guys? But logic wahi hai. Ki link nahi baith raha hai. So wo link bithana bahut zaruri hai. Even if you don't arrive at a beautiful order like 3, 1, 5, 4, it's okay. At least you know ki 1 and 3 are linked together because of the Miller narration. You know that 5 and 4 are linked to each other because it talks about rugby being less popular and now it's beginning to gain an audience. 2, on the other hand, it says they picked rugby. So this shows that rugby is popular. But it had less appeal. No. So rugby popular hua kaise? Iske liye, to introduce this, we need a contradiction word. But, however, although, though. Which 2 does not provide us, but 4 provides us. So 5 ke baad 2 ke jaga, 5 ke baad 4 hona chahiye, mainly also because of this contradiction word. Clear guys? Make sense? Come on, let's look at the other themes or patterns. Now, very important to understand this guys. Very crucial. You have to understand that odd one out, directions, in the directions also it's clearly mentioned ki If there are five sentences, four statements form a logically coherent paragraph. One statement is not a part of that paragraph. So you have to remember that we have to select a statement which is not a part of the same paragraph. It can be from the same article. It can be related to the remaining sentences. It can be completely on point. It can be based on the same topic. It can be from the same article, but it's not necessarily from the same paragraph. This is very important to note. Okay, it's a statement from the same article, can be, but not from the same paragraph, right? So come on guys, read the question and then we'll discuss this. Come on, everybody, try out this question, figure out the odd one out, keeping this in mind. Come on, very important lesson to be learnt. Come on everyone, try this out. Come on guys, 100% accuracy, that's our goal. Who said VARC does not have concepts? VARC has concepts. VARC has rules. VARC has techniques, strategy. There are a lot of things, guys, that you wouldn't have even thought about. So it's very, very important to watch out the space for more, to come regularly to our sessions as well. And take the Plus subscription. Go to the special classes as well. And while taking the Plus subscription, only Ritu MBA. No other code. Come on, everyone. Statement from the same article could be because it's on point, it's related to the question, it's relevant, but not from the same para. Continuation, it could be from the next para, which is, I'll tell you guys, this is the way in which questions are framed. Ek article liya jata hai, ek para uthaya jata hai, that para is broken into four chunks, those four chunks are jumbled. One sentence is taken from the next para, one statement is taken from the last, one statement is lifted from anywhere else in the article and given as your fifth sentence. And then you have to select the odd one out. So if they are smart, we are smart too. So we have to keep this in mind. Come on. Okay, so let's analyze this. I hope you've all gone through this, TK, and you have understood ki, see, this talks about class equitable culture. In the workplace, class has many facets. This also talks about class in terms of an organization. This also talks about class, right? Again, in terms of organization, higher class people are thought to be more responsible and probably hired recruitment mein unko zyada preference diya jata hai. Class difference, again, this talks about class difference. This says in India, okay, now. I'm sure that most of you, if I were to ask you which is the odd one out, and if you were able to tell me and type in, I don't know, at least 50% of you would have said that 5 is your odd one out, because you feel that this is talking about English. This is talking about language. It's not necessarily talking about class, where the other statements are talking about class. So you would have treated this as an apples and oranges approaches. So what have I told you, that approach does not work out. That approach, because the questions are now smarter, guys. The questions are now advanced level. So just by looking at the statements and saying, okay, this option does not have the main word, so I'm going to take that as my odd one out, does not always work out now. So 5 is not your odd one out. Okay, it's very important to understand that apples and oranges, this question also debunks the myth ki sab basic odd one out hote nahi. So if you've taken 5 as your odd one out because you've thought that it's talking about English, and it's talking about presentation and articulation and dressing, the others are not talking about that, then 5 is your odd one out? No. So that's why it's very important to build links. It's very important to understand the theme of the passage. It's very important to understand continuation. But basically link, guys. Aap ye ek word yaad rakhoge in odd one out, ki link is important, then nothing can stop you from achieving 100% accuracy. So link, this is a crucial word. Now understand this. Come on everyone. Look at statement 3. 3 says here. Where? Here candidates that belong to the higher classes are thought to be worthy of being responsible for money. Where? In India. 3 and 5 are related to each other. Here, where? Which other statement talks about where? 3 and 5 are related to each other. Here means a place. Where? Where in India? language clues are very crucial. Right. Plus, now understand this. Look at statement number one. In a day-to-day workplace, achieving a class equitable culture may seem daunting, but a few steps can go a long way. It's like a solution. Theek hai? A few steps. My question is, which are those few steps? A few steps. Big, big, big. Lots and lots and lots of question marks. A few steps can go a long way. Which are those few steps? Which option gives you the steps? Ye problem bata raha hai. Three is also talking about like a problem ki higher class people are preferred. Class difference in four as well. Five also talks about a recruiter ka decision biased ho sakta hai. So which is the only statement, which other statements are talking about the steps? So this is definitely a part of the same article, but it's not a part of this para. This is going to probably be your start. One is going to be the start of the next paragraph where the author lists those steps. So one is your odd one out. Your odd one out in this question becomes one. Did all of you understand this? It's not just by apples and oranges, guys. Sirf keyword dekhe chaloge. You might think ki, you know, itna time. No, guys. See, you have to understand that 2 minutes is what you have to spend on an odd one out question. If you're doing that, it's not a luxury. It's an essential, essential hai. Itna time limit spend karna, itna time spend karna essential hai. Also understand that if you get it wrong, you might feel that there's no negative marking, but you get it wrong and the other person who built links, who took a minute extra probably, gets it right, gets +3, which has a difference of thousands of ranks, which creates a difference of thousands of ranks. So it's very important to focus on these patterns, get it right, build links. Half a minute extra, 1 minute extra, 60 seconds ke andar nahi answer hota. And I'm sure that most of you who are watching this video and who have been with me through my sessions before would understand my first rule ki para jumble or odd one out, 60 seconds se pehle answer mat karna. So please remember this, build links, understand the advanced odd one approach rather than the basic odd one out approach. So when you say few steps, where are those few steps mentioned? Those few steps are not mentioned. So that is why this is definitely a part of the same article, class equitable culture, very, very on point. But it is the start of a next para or a new para, or it's from another para in the article which lists down these few steps. Got it, everyone? It's independent as well, because few steps aur kaha diya hai, we couldn't find it. So one becomes your odd one out. Clear? Okay, come on. Let's have a look at the next approach. Inconsistent with the theme of the passage. You have to understand why the paragraph has been written. What is the main point that the author wants to draw? Or what is the main point that the author wants to convey? Which sentence does not fit into that theme? Which statement could, you know, the paper setters could have just taken the keywords and Googled and put it there. But it's not necessarily a part of this passage. So we'll talk more about this. Just go through this question once. Come on, everyone. Inconsistent with the theme of the passage. Kindly or please understand the theme of the passage here. Come on. The rest of the sentences are talking about point A, are contributing to point A. Which statement is not contributing to that point? Come on, everyone. Very important pointers, very important perspectives, guys, on how to select the best odd one out. Why is it important, guys? You all know the importance of odd one out. Three questions aasani se aate hain. So, all 9 marks, right? 9 marks. Huge difference in your percentile. It can make a difference from going to IMA se lekar koi dusra college tak. Itna difference create kar sakta hai ek odd one out question. So focus, come on. Inconsistent with the theme of the passage. Lot of language clues to help you here as well in order to build links. Okay. Come on, everyone. Dimag ki batti jalao. Come on. Okay. So I hope you've gone through the question and you have selected your odd one out. Now let's see if you are correct or not. Okay. So guys, the odd one out in this question is 2. Okay. So 2 is the answer. Those who have got it wrong, listen carefully. Those who have got it right, please check your approach and strategy. Now, if you've had a look at the entire passage, let's clear things up a little. Okay. Objectively, however, this is an industry. Cannot be my opening sentence. That has sustained countless families. Focus on this. However, contradiction word. It has sustained countless families. This is positive. So, isse pehle, the sentence which we have to put has to be negative. All of you will agree. There hasn't been a socio-economic study of Vietnamese Americans and nail salon work over the past 45 years. There hasn't been. Okay. Not all Vietnamese want to be associated with that struggle. They don't want to be associated with that struggle. Negative. So, isse pehle hum log kya lagayenge? Because there is a but, it needs to be a contradiction. So, we'll put a positive sentence. And it was class embarrassment that kept me away. This is also negative. This says and. So, isse pehle kya lagayenge? Negative sentence lagayenge. Always select an odd one out in a para jungle question which gives you so many grammar links, guys. There should be a big smile on your face. The economic impact the salon had on Vietnamese refugees turned nail salon workers is huge. It had on Vietnamese refugees turned. Turned means who had become. So these Vietnamese refugees who had come from Vietnam, they became or they turned nail salon workers. They started working in nail salons. And this nail salon, this industry had a huge economic impact on them. So this is positive. This is positive. Okay. Now, understand this. 1 cannot be my opening sentence. 3 cannot be my opening sentence. 4 cannot be my opening sentence. Okay. 2 can be your opening sentence. 5 can be your opening sentence. Now, if you're stuck, don't select an opening sentence. Just start with a statement and see what links you can build. So let's say I'm starting with 5. The economic impact that salon had on Vietnamese refugees who turned nail salon workers is huge. So Vietnamese refugees, these are why Vietnamese Americans, these are refugees who had come into America and they turned nail salon workers is huge. Okay, so this is positive. Now let's look at 3 and 4. Not all Vietnamese want to be associated with that struggle. They don't want to be associated with it. There is class embarrassment that kept the author away from the salon also growing up. So there is some sort of a negative image which was attached to this work. However, this is an industry that has sustained countless families. Now, if you understand the theme of the passage, is not about a study or a survey which has been conducted or not been conducted. The theme of the passage is, though nail salon Vietnamese refugees, they became nail salon workers. It was not considered as a very prestigious job. There was class embarrassment which was associated with it. It was considered as a low job or it was considered as a menial job. But still, it was a crucial job because it sustained countless families. So what is the theme? The theme is not about the study. Which other statement talks about the study? Again, ye independent reh jata hai. This is not the theme. The theme of the passage is basically, look at this, 5. It had a very positive impact. Now, it's huge, positive. How do we move to a negative statement now? Look at 3. But not all Vietnamese wanted to be associated with that struggle. 3 se pehle humko positive lagana hi tha. So we put 5-3 together. 3 was negative na. So and lagayenge uske baad. There was class embarrassment. People did not want to be associated with this while growing up. So ye positive tha. Iske baad negative laga diya. However, this is an industry that has sustained. After this 5, which again brings it on a positive note. So positive, but 3. And 4, because 3 and 4 are negative, however 1. So we have used the logic, we have used the language clues also perfectly well, and we have understood ki theme ye tha ki this was an important work. It had a huge economic impact. What economic impact? It sustained countless families. They did not want to be associated with that struggle. Why? Because of class embarrassment. 3-4 is a clear link. 5 and 1 also are clearly linked to each other. So, 2 bichara odd one out reh jata hai. Got it, guys? theme of the passage, why the author has written the passage, or what is the basis for this passage. Okay, now come on, let's have a look at the last two bases of selecting an odd one out. Come on, it contradicts the other statements. This is easy to find out, but oversight, guys. Agar aapko ye wala odd one out nahi mile, that is because of oversight, that is because of not paying attention to the words, that's because it's a silly error, which is actually the worst error to make, because it proves costly, though we could have got it right. So come on, guys, try this out and then we'll understand what contradicting the other statements really means. Come on, everyone, go through this quickly. Fadafat, chalo. Come on. Contradicts the other statements. What could that mean? Come on, everyone. Frame links, pairs banao, subsets banao. Come on, guys. Subsets very crucial to make. Pairing very, very crucial. Come on, guys. Okay, look at one. Upstarts, that is new companies, have also priced a share of the market from the country's five leading winemakers. Positive here. It says that even new industries, new companies are doing well in winemaking. As a result, a wine industry that had seemed on the verge of a breakthrough is now plateauing. It seemed on the verge of a breakthrough. Matlab ab farega, ab breakthrough hoga. There's going to be major success. Is now plateauing. It seemed on the verge of a breakthrough, but it's now plateauing. Plateauing matlab it's going flat. Plateauing in itself is not a negative word. In itself, plateauing is not a negative word. Going flat is fine. But understand this. It was on the verge of a breakthrough. It was meant to rise, but now it's plateauing. So this means that it's negative. Wine industry ab thanda chal raha hai ya stable chal raha hai. Wine producers, having invested in new technology, consultants have begun to win awards. This says that it's rising. The good news for Turkish wines. Which country are you talking about? Turkey. Quality has improved. Again, it's on the rise. The new boutique companies have pushed the big ones to make better wine. There is an improvement. So all the other statements, 5, 4, 3 and 1 are all talking about a breakthrough, are all talking about improvement, better wines. They are all talking about a rise. But 2 is talking about a flat curve, plateauing. So which statement contradicts the others? Or agar contradict karna bhi hai, to but low, however low, grammatically also, it's contradicting and it's not even justifying the contradiction. जैसे पहले स्टेटमेंट में कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन था तो बट यूज हुआ था हाउएवर यूज हुआ था देन ओनली यू कैन गो फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव और नेगेटिव टू पॉजिटिव सो लॉजिकली दिस फेल्स बिकॉज इट कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट्स द रेस्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंसेस एंड ग्रामेटिकली ऑल्सो इट फेल्स सो योर ऑड वन आउट क्लियरली इन दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर गाइज डन कम ऑन लेट्स लुक एट द नेक्स्ट बेस द लास्ट बेसिस कम ऑन एवरीवन लीस्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन और डिस्पेंसिबल स्टेटमेंट Dispensable statement, matlab again, all five statements are linked to each other. All five statements look like they belong to the same para. But kaun sa itna important nahi hai? Which statement is not that crucial ki hume use rakhna hi hai? Which statement we can let go of? Theek hai, isko nikal dete hai, isko eliminate kar dete hai. Because we can stay without it, we can live without it. Come on everyone, try this out. So there are five sentences on your screen. Chalo. फटाफट अरेंज करो एंड टेल विच इज द ऑड वन आउट कम ऑन गाइज आई यू हैव टू गेट दिस राइट नाउ कम ऑन लुक्स नॉट नेसेसरी इतनी जरूरत नहीं है बाकी सेंटेंसेस आर मोर इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दे आर मोर क्लोजली लिंक्ड अगेन द टॉक कम्स अराउंड यू नो अगेन द वर्ड The key word is link. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Very important question time, guys. Focus on all of these pointers that we have discussed today. Theme samjho, links banao, independent statement dhundo, last one out through categorization, which is not that important, which is from the same article but not from the same paragraph. Very, very crucial inputs. Come on. Okay, so I'm sure that you've all arrived at your odd one out now. So guys, let's understand it. So the odd one out in this question is one. Now let's see this. So most of you might have aap log soch rahe ho ki one kaise, one ko to hum log four se link kar sakte hai, but let's understand this. Look at this. Flamingos, for example, are well known for their gregarious habits and aggregations in large flocks, means they are social. Captive sorry guys, captive birds provide a useful model for investigating aspects of social choice in highly gregarious, long-lived species. Captive birds. Captive populations, therefore, provide a useful alternative to some other method for measuring social choices. Investigating, measuring. Animals invest in social relationships that convey fitness benefits and bonds can be long-lasting. For some species, field-based measurement. Agar hum theme se bhi leke chale, guys, one is your odd one out because all the other statements are talking about measurement. They are talking about investigation. They are talking about how to find out. How to find out what? How to find out these social relationships within animal groups or within species. Understand this now. See, when you say grammar links are very crucial, captive populations therefore provide a useful alternative. Alternative to what? Field based measurement. 5 and 3 are definitely going to be linked to each other because field based measurement can be difficult. So field matlab on site, matlab reality mein, natural habitat, so that can be difficult. So you can study this in captive populations. That can be a useful alternative. Why it can be a useful alternative? The benefit of that is provided. What are you testing? You're testing, obviously, one cannot be your opener, correct? So which is your opener? 4. Okay, for some species of what? Animals. Okay, so 4, 5, 3, 2 becomes a link. Now is this example really that important? Is it adding anything? Look at all the other statements. They are adding something. 4 provides the opener. Without this, you will not even have an opener. So 4 to bahut hi zaruri hai. They provide a useful alternative. Alternative to what? 5 and 3 are grammatically linked to each other. Agar 5 nahi hai, to 3 ko aap alternative nahi bol sakte ho. So 5 and 3 are useful, and without 3, 2 also cannot come. Because 3 and 2 are talking about how captive birds or captive populations are better. How they can, be used for this investigation. Now, nobody is asking, it's not about example ki haan aise hai. Now, I can agree with your point ki definitely it can be a part of this passage. It could probably be an example of 4. But is it necessary? Is it directly linked to any other statement, or can we do without it? We can do without it. It is dispensable. So that is why your odd one out in this question becomes 1. Clear, guys? I hope you've picked up these clues. Now, let's do a quick revision of all this. Apples and oranges, 3 statements talking about one apples, 1 statement talking about oranges, odd one out. Be very careful, not the suggested approach, definitely not the suggested approach. Abhi ke cap pattern ko dekhkar, you might come out very happy and beaming out of the exam thinking ki odd one out to far diya ekdam. But guys, trust me, most of the times you might miss out a keyword, miss out a link. So isko thoda sa cautiously use karna. Logical sequence, the best approach, form links. Whichever comes as the last one out or whichever does not fit anywhere becomes your odd one out. Independent statement, which is not directly linked to any other statement, which could be from a different article altogether. It can be from the same article but from a different paragraph. It talks about a new point. It talks about a new idea. It talks about a continuation. Inconsistent with the theme of the passage. Why has the author written the passage and which option does not fit or contribute to that theme? Contradicts the other statements and contradicts without even using a contradictory word, but, however, although. लीस्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन करता है, डिस्पेंसिबल है, जरूरी नहीं है, तो टीम से निकाल दो. सो दैट बिकम्स योर ऑड वन आउट. क्लियर गाइज? आई होप दिस सेशन इज प्रूविन वेरी यूजफुल. प्लीज वॉच दिस, प्लीज शेयर, लाइक, सब्सक्राइब, फॉरवर्ड, लेट ऑल योर फ्रेंड्स बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दिस, बिकॉज दिस इज द best source where you can, this is the best video guys for finding out all the different patterns and all the different types and all the different bases of odd one out. Thoda sa sink in hone ke liye time lagega. Video bar bar dekho, repeat pe dekho, but understand these patterns. These are like your rules, these are like your is, you know, this is like your constitution on which you have, you know, for your odd one out. So it's very crucial. Please focus on this. Take the subscription, guys. Want to see all of you in our subscription classes, in the plus classes, learn more, pick up from here and try out various question types. Ki CAT 2020 ho ya CAT 2021 ho ya SNAP ho, jo bhi exam ho guys, ZAT ho, TIS ho, IFT ho, aisa koi bhi question type hamare saamne nahi aaye jo humne try nahi kiya ho. So for that, you have to take the subscription and only using the code RITUMBA. Take the subscription, guys. 10% off all your friends and family, whoever is planning for any of these examinations. Kisi ko bhi admission lena hai, subscription lena hai, Ritu MBA. Press the like button, share button, subscribe button. Watch out the space for the live classes. And classes attend mat karna, bhulna Unacademy learning app pe. So bye, guys. Until I see you next time, take care.